as a heavy chemo, but she got near a flu. I don't know what they're doing to her. She will come back. I know. Yeah. Let's worry about her dying down there or something. We never see her again. She can go to sleep and die and just never wake up, and then we never saw her. That's scary.
Yes.
You're worrying too much. You don't know anything can happen. You know, she's sick now and on chemo, but why is it weakens her heart with more less blood cells? Because the chemo already drained some blood cells. Now that flu drained more. Her heart can give up. She can get a cardiac arrest or she can die in her sleep. She can just drop dead. Because there's a little infection or something because you put her near someone that's infected with sickness. That's why people are Tina's dumb. You're not supposed to bring chemo patients around sick people. It's just like taking a chemo patient, even though you had to go to ER, even by AMA still, but or it's just kind of like bringing them to a place that has a massive cold, so it's set them around people that are sneezing and coughing around at ER waiting and having to breathe it in. It's like you're like feeding them poison. Then you go in, what they're going in for, oh, yeah, I have this, oh, yeah, that's good, but then you come back home 2 days later, and then they get really sick and then their bodies can't fight infections already because of all that blood cells, and they get these even natural infections that your body fights off, like on the end, and it kills you. That's what my mom has to worry about now, is like she always had to worry about bodily infections turning into some nightmare. Now she has chemo, having the flu, way blood cells down, and mom could have a normal colon infection that her body can fight. Now she could get sick as a dog on the end, or stomach infection, boom, ICU. How mad I'll be.